great 4th of July celebration, 4th of July weekend. So here is the lineup for this year. We'll begin again with videos of local bands on the big screen. Thanks to our partner KPAO, Omaha's Community Television, for producing these videos. Spotlighting local bands has been very popular since we started doing this 3 years ago. Then first on stage is a teen heartthrob from the 60s, Carrie and I, he was our heartthrob too. The opening act is Herman's Hermits, starring Peter Noon. The hits include some of his hits, Mrs. Brown, You've Got a Lovely Daughter, There's a Kind of Hush, and I'm Into Something Good. Herman's Hermits had 11 top 10 hits in the United States between 1964 and 1967. Now, in 1964, I was 10 years old, so you could figure that out. And our 2023 headliner is singer, songwriter, and guitarist Melissa Etheridge. She's a Grammy award-winning songwriter and hits and singer, and the hits include Come to My Window, I'm the Only One, and Bring Me Some Water. She has released 7 albums, selling more than 25 million copies. She won an Oscar for the Best Original Song, written for the documentary An Inconvenient Truth. She has performed on Broadway and published her first book, an autobiography, in 2001. The night will end with one of the largest fireworks displays in the Midwest, always bigger and better than the year before. This concert is staged every year in beautiful Memorial Park. Matt Kalsovich is our parks director. He's here with me today. Matt and his team always do such a great job getting the park ready and then fixing the park up after the concert is over. So I want to invite Matt up to speak now. Matt?
Thank you, Mayor. First, we are incredibly excited about this date and a return to the Friday before the week of 4th of July. We know in the last few years we've had an August date and a July date, and we will remain flexible moving forward to really try and bring the greatest talent we can recruit with our partner to this show and have that be part of our great summer season. This year signifies something extra special, and that is the 75th anniversary of Memorial Park. We will have several events throughout the year, as well as a significant and unique statue, the Embracing Peace statue that's been announced, will be a presence in the park for the summer, including the time of the concert. I do also want to thank, as the mayor did, our Parks and Recreation team for their hard work in preparation for this event. This is one that I know personally I and they are always very excited about getting ready for, as it is such a tremendous part of our summer. We'd also like to thank the Omaha Parks Foundation, a longtime partner of the Parks Department and supporter of this event, and to the Executive Director, Tiffany Regan, for all of her support. We'd also like to mention and recognize VGA, our promotional and management partner, who we've worked with for the last several years. We have an incredibly strong dynamic, and they are somebody we look forward to working with now and for years to come. If you're looking for more event details, and we suggest you do this as we approach the date of the concert, for info about parking, street closures, park rules, and any other updates about the event, visit us at memorialparkconcert.com, or you can also find information by searching Memorial Park Concert on Facebook. Thank you.
Thank you. Well, it takes a lot of coordination to stage this event. Besides our Parks Department, Omaha Police and Fire, Park Omaha, and our media partners, Summit Media, and station Star 104.5, make sure that this is a really great event. We just have to keep our fingers crossed and pray that we have good weather, because I can't remember how many years we had a big thunderstorm when right before the park opened and people started coming, but I do think last year was great, so it was the year before. So keep your fingers crossed, but it should be a really good event again this year. Questions?
Have we done anything special to the park to prepare for this?
So in relation to the statue that's coming in, we're building a new platform that will serve as an event venue for us in years to come, and maybe a place where we'll host something special like we're doing with the statue that's coming. Obviously going through a lot of the regular improvements we do in the spring to activate the park when things really start to grow and refine those things in preparation for the events as we do every year. So those things are in motion now with the great weather that we're all seeing. Those are really going to take off.
Crystal ball question, any idea how many people might show up this year?
Oh, on average?
It was last year. I think we estimated last year we had You remember? We had a lot.
Yeah.
How about a lot?
50,000.
How about
it's,
that?
It's been in the range, and Heidi with VGA has referenced some of that in the past for us, too, anywhere between 50 and 75,000. Really
right,
just
Vic?
A little bit about the weather and
all about weather.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yep.
Last couple of years, it has been hot and sunny there. Really hot, mm-hmm. but good.
Quite a few people, for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Any other questions?
Privately funded through the foundation?
Once again, yes. Absolutely. Other questions? And we really want to thank our donors. The primary donor chooses to remain anonymous, but they make this event really great every year, and we're very appreciative, especially the fireworks, too, afterwards. They just get better and better,
yeah.
So that'll be really great. Other questions?
If nobody has questions about the concert series.
Well, let's finish the concert. Any other questions? You guys are easy today.
Uh-huh.
All right, we'll see you there at the concert then. Thank you. Thank you very much. Yes?
One question about